Hi everyone, welcome to this exercise. In the previous units, we have discussed that in Water Accounting Plus, we reclassify all land cover categories into four main types of Water Accounting Plus land use categories. These categories are protected land use, utilized land use, managed land use, and managed water use categories. One of the steps in Water Accounting Plus is to calculate precipitation, evapotranspiration, and rainfall and incremental components of evapotranspiration per this Water Accounting Plus land use categories. In this exercise, we will compute precipitation, rainfall evapotranspiration, incremental evapotranspiration, and water balance for Litani River Basin in Lebanon. Please make sure to download the data for this exercise from the course platform and adjust the paths to the input files as needed. The zipped data file contains this Jupyter notebook, a CSV file containing the WAPOR land cover class codes and names, area and reservoir tip files, and two NetCD files. We will start by importing the required package and getting the paths to the input files. These input files contain a CSV file containing the land cover categories information, an SCD file of the land cover categories, which is obtained from WAPOR, an SCD file which contains monthly precipitation, evapotranspiration, incremental and rainfall evapotranspiration, and change in storage for Litani River Basin, area tip file, which contains the area of each grid in a square kilometer, and a reservoir tip file, which contains or shows the area of the reservoir in the basin. We read first the CSV file, which contains the land cover categories information. And we inspect that. As you can see, this data frame contains the land cover class names and their code, which also can be downloaded from WAPOR. We convert this data frame into a dictionary for ease of use later on. So if we see the dictionary, as the land cover description or names as its key and the code as its value. We use XRA to open the NetCD files. Also, we use XRA to open the area and the reservoir tip files. And here we create a list which contains the type of land cover which are in the managed land use and managed water use categories. We know that rain-fed cropland and fallow cropland belongs to the managed land use category, whereas irrigated cropland, built-up areas, and man-made reservoirs belong to the managed water use categories. So we do that by running this script, and we reclassify the WAPOR land cover class into Water Accounting land use categories. So let's assign codes to Water Accounting Plus land use categories. And let's say the protected land use as code of 1, utilized land use as code 2, managed land use as code 3, and managed water use has port 4. Let's get the land cover class data array, and then we copy that into a land water land use or water accounting land use data array, and we make everything first to be a utilized land use because that is the majority of the land use. So we assign to everything code of 2 by this line, and then we assign the area which is covered by reservoirs code number 4 because reservoirs belong to managed water use, and we assign areas covered by the managed land use classes such as rainfed croplands code of 3 because they belong to the managed land use, and land cover classes such as built up areas and rainfed irrigated crops belong to the managed water use code, so we assign them code 4. So by doing this, we will have the water accounting land use categories data. Now we can plot both the WAPOR land cover category and the water accounting plus land use categories and inspect the difference. Here it is. So the first is the WAPOR land cover categories, which as you can see has about 15 different land cover categories, whereas this, the second one, has only 3 water accounting plus land use categories. Normally we say in water accounting we have 4 land use categories, but since in Litani Basin there is no protected land, we have only 3 types of water accounting land use categories. Next, we will compute the volumes of precipitation, evapotranspiration, and change in storage per land use water accounting land use categories. And we do that by running this function. We compute the volume of precipitation and actually evapotranspiration and the change in storage for the whole basin, and we compute incremental and rainfall evapotranspiration per water accounting land use classes. How do we do that? For example, for precipitation, if we multiply the precipitation data array with the area, we get the volume, and we divide that by 1000 to change the unit. So we have now the volume with unit of million cubic meter per year. And for incremental evapotranspiration and rainfall evapotranspiration, we also compute the volumes per the 4 water accounting land use categories. And once this computation is finished, it writes the data into a data frame, and we can read that data frame and inspect. And the data frame looks like this. So for year 2016, we have the volumes given here. So for precipitation, we have 1297 cubic meter per year. For actual evapotranspiration is shown here. For the blue component of the evapotranspiration is this much. whereas the green component of the transpiration is given. And for the blue and the green component of the evapotranspiration, we calculate also per water accounting plus land use categories, and they are given. And we have the change in storage in the basin also calculated here. So from water balance approach, if you remember, we can calculate the discharge out of the basin from the water balance equation. So we have the precipitation as an input, actual evapotranspiration as output, and the change in storage. So if we have these three components, then the discharge will be precipitation minus evapotranspiration minus change in storage. So by running this, you can calculate the outflow from the river. And finally, we can plot the data frame to see, visualize the relative importance of these different volumes in the basin. This is all about computing precipitation and evapotranspiration per water accounting plus land use categories. I hope you will be able to run this exercise, and if you have problems, please post them into the discussion forum. And hope to see you in the next videos. Bye.